Being a dick and wrestling is synonymous. It's the same thing. It took me a long time to realize this because I did jiu-jitsu and you're very like nice to your opponent in jiu-jitsu. You don't try to like break their arm and stuff. So this was a long lesson for me to learn. The definition of wrestling is being a dick. In a match, which is what you practice for, you are trying to inflict your will onto your opponent, right? And the more time you spend inflicting the most will you possibly can on your opponent in practice, the better you'll be in an actual match. In wrestling, you can't be afraid of anyone or anything, right? And the only reason you wouldn't be a dick to your partner in wrestling, and when I say being a dick, I don't mean bending his finger back or locking hands and slamming him or like hurting him. I mean wrestling hard. I mean hard wrestling with proper form, with no illegal shit, no headbutts, no just hard wrestling, hard snaps, hard shots, hard turning the corner, everything hard. With that in mind, you cannot be afraid of anyone or anything. You cannot take anyone's shit. You cannot let anyone inflict their will on you. You know what I mean? You cannot take that shit. You do not take anyone's shit. You're a wrestler. You look out for yourself, okay? You look out for the team. You and your team are a family, but in the wrestling room, you guys are partners. You guys are grinding each other down. Iron sharpens iron. You know what I mean? You guys are trying to get sharper, hone your skills. And when you wrestle hard, when you're a dick, this pushes your speed. Every day that you push your speed, you push how quickly you can get to someone's legs, then you get better. The average person gets 1% better every day. Then someone who wrestles hard and to the best of their ability gets 2% better. Does that make sense? And the gap grows pretty quickly. Like, you soar above the competition really fast when you start being a dick, right? If you're JV, being a dick for a season could get you the varsity spot. If you're varsity, being a dick could get you to win a tournament. If you're winning tournaments, then it could get you to the state tournament. You know what I mean? It could just push you further. Humans work in such a way that once we are shown adversity, once we are shown the inability to do something, if we continue to go at it, we will overcome it. Does that make sense? So if you are trying to like get faster, if you're trying to hone your ability to distract your opponent, level change, and get to the legs as quickly as possible, your brain will get more and more used to firing off that same command every single day that it does it. And the harder that it fires it off, the better it's gonna get. The better it's gonna get after you recover, and it doesn't take much. You don't realize you're getting better when you're getting better. You only realize it in competition, all right? And it's not a secret how you get better, it's just really hard. When you're wrestling hard, like in live matches, you start, once you get the concept of chain wrestling down and you're wrestling hard, you start thinking of new things. You come up with new things. You try new things that you've never done. You really conceptualize the human body and how it works in a wrestling match. Like how a wrestler reacts to certain things, what they do, how to shift the weight, how to break one of their posts, like a leg or an arm if they're putting weight on it, how to control different parts of their body with a half or a tight waist. You know what I mean? You learn these things a lot quicker and a lot more in depth when you're trying to force your opponent to do this, when he's resisting you and you're doing it anyway. And by far the most important part of being a dick while wrestling is when you pin your opponent in live wrestling, when you get his back to the mat, you've won. That doesn't mean continue pinning him and have him fight, right? You're just helping him remain a pussy, just staying on his back. What you do is you back off of him, you give him a little, like, you give him half a second to get up, and if he doesn't get up, you shove him to the ground. You shove him straight to the ground, back to his butt. And you give him half a second again, if he doesn't get up, you shove him back to the ground. And you keep on doing this until the bell rings, all right? You control this kid. You control your opponent. Be a dick. Don't be a pussy. If you guys like that video, hit the like button, hit the subscribe button. I'm gonna post another video tomorrow, but until next time, I'll see you guys. Peace.